Hello everyone, this is Vamsidhar, founder of www.pacegurus.com, training and consulting venture in the area of finance and analytics. In this video, let's try to see the usage of Xirr and Xnpv formulas. Why do we really need to use them and what kind of benefits they have over the normal NPV and IRR formulas. Now, some of you who might have used the NPV and IRR, just to give a quick background of those formulas, if at all an investment has been made into a particular project or an assignment, and that particular assignment is expected to give some kind of returns in future. For example, I have made 110 million as an investment today, which is 17th December 2012, and I am expecting 37 million return in the next 1 year on 15th January 2014, and similarly some 15 million on 26th August 2015, and so on. Now, if I want to find out what is the overall return on this entire investment, how much return I am getting, this is not so easy, for the simple reason I am investing something today and I am getting the returns in parts. It is not one single sum which I am receiving, which is a real business scenario. We would be receiving different amounts at different points in time. Understanding the concept of time value of money, it's better to find out the return during this entire period, and that entire process can be facilitated by the use of IRR and NPV functions. If I want to find out the return for the entire period, it's better to use a formula called IRR. Now, I'll tell you why XIRR will come into picture, but if I use IRR equal to IRR, where I'll give the list of all these cash flows, where there is a cash outflow today and probably cash inflows and outflows at some point in time in the future. Now, this is giving me that the IRR in this case is 18.21%. What it means is, in this investment, my average annual return is 18.21%. So, if I am very much happy with getting 18.21% per year, I should look at investing in this project. Otherwise, this investment is not a good investment for me. Now, if IRR is the internal rate of return, which is nothing but the return which this particular investment is generating, this is a very important formula in the world of finance. But in this example, I will not use IRR. I will use XIRR to get a better output, a better return figure. Why? The reason being, IRR becomes a very good formula to use only when the time periods of receiving as well as investing, there is equal width in the time periods. But in our case, it's not the case. Here we have almost 13 months, then we have close to 1.5 years. Then the gap is only 2 months. Then again, almost 2+ years. So, the gaps between the various cash flows is not uniform. If the gaps between the various time periods is not uniform, IRR as an Excel formula will fail. The concept is still IRR, but as an Excel formula, IRR as a formula will not give me a better output of the return, especially when the time periods are spaced much differently. The spacing between the time periods of the different cash flows, if it is drastically different, I should not use IRR, I should use XIRR. If that's the case, what's that extra benefit which the XIRR brings over the typical IRR formula? The XIRR takes into consideration the dates of the cash flows also. Whereas the normal IRR makes an assumption that each value which you are entering is one period different, is having a difference of one time period, whether it is month or years or whatever. So in this case, it makes an assumption that you have invested 110 today, because we have put minus here. You have invested 110 million today. You are getting 37 million after one period, whatever may be the period. The period should be a uniform period. You are getting 37 after one period, 15 after two periods, 12 after three periods. So the definition of the period is a uniform length of time. But in case of XIRR, that assumption is not made. Even if the periods are of different length, the XIRR as a formula will give me the overall return this project is generating. So in case of formulas where the cash flows, different cash flows are generated at different time periods and even they are not equally spaced, in Excel I suggest the use of XIRR function to find out what is the rate of return in this entire investment. So I'll use the formula equal to XIRR. Here the inputs wise, it asks for values and dates. These are the values. So as you remember, in case of IRR, only values were asked, dates were not asked. So because this is an extended version of the IRR, it asks for values as well as the dates, and based on that it computes the return. So going by this, the return percentage in this example is only 15.92%, not 18.21. There is a big difference of close to 2.25% between both the mechanisms. The real return which you are getting in this kind of an investment is only 15.92% and not 18.21%. So you have to be very careful in using this IRR formula. At the end, both IRR and XIRR are handling or performing the same kind of a function, same kind of a business logic. In the sense, both will tell you what is the overall return in your investment from the time of investment to the, by taking into consideration the various cash flows occurring at different points in time. IRR is a special case of XIRR where all the cash flows are occurring at equally spaced intervals. Wherever we have a business scenario where the cash flows don't occur at equally spaced intervals, we should depend on XIRR. Now, let's move on to the next function, NPV versus XNPV. As you all know, NPV is the net of the present values. net of all the present values that are going to occur in future. If these are the different present values that are going to occur, these are the total cash flows that are going to occur at different points in time in future, and the investor is having a 15% return objective. He is having, or probably a 17%, 16% return objective. A 16% return, which means the investor, he, based on his risk priority, he is expecting a return of 16% on any investment which he is going to make. If based on the 16% expectation, if the returns of this project, if the cash inflows are more than the cash outflows, based on a discounting of 16%, there would definitely be an investment in the project, because it would be profitable for this investor. Whereas if the present value of the cash outflows is more than the present value of the cash inflows, the investor should reject the project, as he cannot invest more than what he can expect out of the project. So the NPV as a function, or XNPV as a function, will give me the present values of all the cash outflows as well as all the cash inflows, and based on them it will find out whether the present value of the cash outflows is greater or the inflows is greater. Based on that, the computation will either come out to be a net of positive or negative. If the net value is positive, it means that the cash outflows are more than the cash inflows after discounting. So accept the project, otherwise reject the project. Now that's how I am using the NPV formula of Excel. Again, the NPV formula takes the rate as well as the values. The rate is what the investor is expecting. 16% is the expectation of the investor, whereas the returns wise, these are the numbers that are coming up. So finally it says a plus $7, which means it is positive and requires a worth investment in the project. But as we have discussed, this NPV takes into consideration the different cash flows occurring at equally spaced intervals of time. In case the cash flows are not occurring at equally spaced intervals, just like what we have discussed in case of XIRR, where if the cash flows are occurring at equally spaced intervals, then NPV is still a better tool to use to find out whether the net is a positive cash flow or a negative cash flow. So, because in this example, we are observing that the cash flow is occurring at different time periods which are not equally spaced, it's better to use XNPV formula, which will take into consideration the rate is 16%, the values, these are the values, and these are the dates. Now, based on this, this is telling me that XNPV is minus 0.31. It's coming out to be a negative value, which means, as a conclusion, for an investor who is expecting 16% return annually, this project is not a worth investment because the present value of the cash inflows is lesser than the present value of the cash outflows. It can be cross-verified with your XIRR also. where you can clearly see that the project is giving a return of 15.92% annually, but the investor is expecting 16% return. So the investor's expectation is more than what the return the project is generating. So in this case, obviously the investor should not accept the project. So we can look at the accept and reject criteria both from the XNPV as well as XIRR perspectives. So NPV and IRR are only special cases of XNPV and XIRR where the cash flows are occurring at equally spaced intervals. I hope this session is comfortable. And I hope you are comfortable with the usage of XNPV, XIRR, how they are different from NPV and IRR formulas. So if you have any further queries regarding this, you can feel free to contact me on 9198480-12123. Or you can also send me an email on vamsidhar@pacegurus.com. And also request you to visit our website www.pacegurus.com for any further queries or for updates on further trainings in the areas of finance and analytics at Pace Gurus. Thanks a lot for listening to this session. Thank you very much.